What up? In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to set up an auto splitter and the load remover for Ratatouille Any Percent. The load remover is going to be for the full game, but the auto splitter right now is only made for Any Percent. If there is the NMS version like made and I uploaded it, I might pin that comment. But right now, only the Any Percent thing is done. If you already have a load remover, I will put timestamps into the video description so that you can jump to the auto splitter part. And of course I will put all the links in the description below so that you can instantly download them and don't have to look them up. But first let's start out with the load remover. We're gonna take a live split and we will edit the layout. And here you should make yourself two timers. One is gonna be for RTA, the real-time attack, and one is with the load remover. For one of the timers, you have the option right here. You are here on your both timers. You can set them one to real-time and one to game time. You then want to make sure if you edit your splits that your game is Ratatouille and in brackets Asobo. You can type it in and it will automatically like show up and you can press it. And then it will just have to click activate. And then the one timer, I think it's the upper one, is going to be without loads. So yeah, that's it for the load remover. That's actually quite simple. You don't have to download anything for that. For the auto splitter though, you will have to download this file right here on GitHub. You have to scroll down a little and there's going to be the autosplitter zip file. You can download it right here. I don't need to download it no more. I already have it. Yeah, let's open it up. Right here we have it. It should not look like this if you open up the first time. Okay, so I'm going to also leave a link for this drive folder right here. The Ratatouille autosplitter Any Percent images. You want to download the PKL. Best if you just get it into the folder where you also have your auto split files. I have it right here. Also the images, you can just right click on this folder, download. It's gonna get you a zip file. You have to get also the images in here. Don't change any of these names. This is important. If you change those names, I will tell you about those in a bit. Right now it's not important. So when you have auto split, you will go to file, load settings, into your auto split folder and load the rad folder. Now you have to match some things with your live split. Because what it does not like read the game's files, the game's memory. It will like, on the left we see the capture region. Like it will capture your OBS or a part of your OBS. And from there it's going to compare the images to the current splits. So at first, if this is not shown, you should have OBS opened so that you can do the stuff. Let's go into full screen very quick. So if we have OBS right here, and let's say this is my RAD layout, I want the region to select all of the game that's going to be shown right here. So it should capture that. I'm going to just load the settings that I had before. And also if you do runs, very important, it's something I had struggled with. If you're doing runs, you cannot minimize OBS. You will have. You do not have to have like a second monitor or something. You can just not press that minimize icon. You will have to have it on full screen in the background. Otherwise, the autosplitter will not capture it. Okay, back in autosplitter, very important also, set your FPS the same FPS that your game is running on. And also, if any of those check marks are not the same that they are for me, like live capture region or those four, and auto start or reset, then you should make sure that those boxes are like activated. So the next thing you want to do so that it actually does the inputs for your splits is you want to match the start split, the reset, the skip split, and the undo split with your timer hotkeys. You don't need the pause button necessarily. You don't need it. Let's just go into settings. Right here I have start split, I have return, reset back, undo skip left, skip split right. Let's see if that's actually matched right here. Those are German, so they're all right. They're all the way they should. Just make sure they match so that it doesn't do the wrong inputs and actually nothing happens. So if you're doing runs, you should start the auto splitter. So it will make maybe tell you that it does not have something to compare against. You will have to go to split image folder, go to auto split 1.5, then take the image that I gave you, take that. Then you should be able to start the auto splitter. That should show you this. Now when we are in the game, it's hard to make the timer as accurate as possible, or it's hard to make the timer very accurate. So you'll have to start your run right here. You will not have to do any inputs, that's what the auto splitter is for. So if you go in, the splitter will already start right here. Before you go into the run, make sure that you have your global hotkeys. Wait, let me show that. Make sure you have your global hotkeys activated so that doesn't do nothing. Okay, so in the game, again, make sure that it's actually capturing the stuff that you want to capture. So let's start the auto splitter. Let's get into the game. And you have to prepare for the run right here, like reset the timer and all that. If you press the reset button, that's the only button you will still have to press, or the skip or undo split if something happens that you don't want to happen. The auto splitter should already adjust, so if you press the reset button, it will already bring it back to the state that it will automatically start the run. If I would just press play game, it should start the run right at this point. So I can just go and do the run. Also, you will probably be using other splits, like not the ones that you have right now. I might also upload these in the RAD folder, in the image folder, so that, yeah, you can maybe adjust them, like, or just retime them. Also, I made pretty standard ones. You will also have to get the same amount of splits and the same splits themselves than I do, since it will split for everybody at the same time. Okay, so let's say you've done everything that I've done so far and it doesn't work. There's only one thing that could have gone wrong, and that is the accuracy that you maybe did your capture region. Let's say we have our images right here. We have them all numbered from 1 to 11. They all have like 001, 002, 003 at the beginning. That's like to make them in order so that they don't get mixed up. Next up, we have 0.80 in those things. That means that the picture needs to be about 80% of what your split image needs to look like. I'll just mention again, make sure that your capture region is on OBS right where the game will be. So like that it really does fit in the part where your game is and not like goes over or under. Like I said, for the most images it will only require 80%, like 0.80 means 80%. For things like this, Destiny River, this is where it will split after the tutorial. Like stuff like the hat or my frame counter will not count because it will only take like 90%. So it will think like, yeah, okay, imagine that wasn't there. It's the same picture than you have on your screen. It will maybe also adjust a little bit if it's like a few frames off. Some pictures sometimes can look a bit different. Like let's say this, you might have, like it might split too late if it will be on 90%. So with 80%, it should split as soon as you see the first few frames of this animation. The zero in brackets means basically that's a load remover, as much as I understand. Though, since we already have a load remover and that works way better than this one, we don't need this. And also, I don't know how it would work with LiveSplit, like it doesn't go to LiveSplit and does stuff there. I think it would just pause the game for that amount of time. So yeah, we don't need that at all. Okay, and if adjusting the amount of percentage doesn't work, the only thing that you can do is take the pictures again on your own. Like let's say you're on console or on some other platform where like some text boxes look different or something, like PS2. Mummiger on our server like runs on PS2, he might have different text boxes and stuff. So you will have to do a screenshot of that and you will just have to replace that image with the one that is already in the folder. Also remember to put in the exact same name so that it doesn't get confused or something. I hope I didn't miss anything. If I did, then I will be answering those questions in the comments below or in the description. Thank you for watching, leave a like, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye!